Good evening, everyone. My name is Veronica O'Leary and I am the founder and director of service at Purple House Cancer Support. On behalf of all of us, I would like to extend a warm welcome to you all tonight as we celebrate our first ever online candlelight service and our Lights of Life Christmas tree. For the first time in over 26 years, we are unable to hold our face-to-face candlelight service due to the COVID pandemic. That has affected not only everyone and everything in Ireland, but throughout the whole world. And this year has been like no other. And as we face into a winter like no other, we wanted to offer some light, love and hope to you throughout the next few months. I know so many of you have suffered loneliness, fear and isolation since last March. And for some of you, I know, have suffered heartbreak and losses, including my own family. It can be hard to keep yourself intact and to put a brave face on things, but I believe that we are stronger than we think. And I believe too that this crisis too will pass, and all the heartache, pain, loneliness and fear that is so prevalent amongst so many of us will lessen and ease as we move in to the next era. One of the reasons we choose to have the Lights of Life Christmas tree and the unveiling of our purple brick wall of love was so that we could give light and love out to all around us during this uncertain and challenging time. Out of darkness comes light, and out of sadness can come joy, and out of loneliness can come friendship. Throughout the COVID pandemic, all of us at Purple House were humbled and honoured by the outpouring of volunteerism that came our way from the very beginning. People who had lost their jobs or unable to work picked up the phone to us and offered to drop off food parcels to people living alone, bring them out to hospital for their essential treatment, call in and check that people were all right, and really anything that would help people isolated and alone during this particular time. To me, this is the essence of kindness and compassion in humanity, and it reminded me of a poem that Brendan gave me many years ago. I will pass through this world but once. Any good, therefore, that I can do, or any kindness that I can show to another human being, let me do it now. Let me not defer or neglect it, for I shall not pass this way again. Tonight we are joined by the Purple House Choir under the direction of our guitarist Martin Dodd and also accompanied by Una McFarland and Tanya Farrelly, also on guitar. The Reverend Baden Stanley will join us later for a few words of reflection, and we're all looking forward to that. And Baden has been a loyal supporter and friend of Purple House since he came to Bray over 20 years ago. Katie Boylan, another good friend of Purple House, is going to read one of Nelson Mandela's reflections. And Ross Scanlon will join us to sing O Holy Night. And I know you will love that. And for some of you will know that Ross has been singing with us since he was 16 and he has an incredible voice. Our special thanks and appreciation to Noel Dicker and all his team from GCR for very kindly offering to do a live stream of this very special candlelight service so that we can reach as many of you as we can at home and overseas. Many thanks, Noel. And thank you also to Charlie Sharkey, who is going to go around and take loads of photographs so that we can look back on them in years to come. As always, events like this don't happen, and our thanks and appreciation must go out to our many committed team of volunteers, staff, therapists and friends. We couldn't manage without you, and we appreciate everything you do. This year saw Purple House move into our new permanent community-based cancer support centre. Our new home at 2 Duncairn Terrace, Quinsborough Road, Bray, will be a legacy for many generations to come. The accumulation of this house is the result of many, many hours and weeks of hard work, meetings, negotiations with various ministers, HSE officials, TDs, business organisations and individuals for the past 30 years, but much more so for the past 10 years. We just can't believe it now that we are actually in the house. It even makes the stress and strain of the many ups and downs worthwhile. And I know that you will all love it once you can get inside and come and see it for yourself. Even with all the renovations and the work underway, we are still managing to run our service and ensure that our vital cancer support services are available to you and your loved ones when you need us most. Words aren't enough to express our gratitude and thanks to you, to so many of you, individuals, organisations, business community, and everyone in the community for supporting us over the past 30 years. When I first started out all those years ago and told my story, the community have been there for us and have sustained us. So I am so proud on behalf of everyone that we have this beautiful house that everyone can avail of. It has been some journey to date and exhausting at times, but rest assured your contributions are going to ensure that your community will have a community-based cancer support centre for many, many years to come. Thank you all from the bottom of our hearts for all you do and continue to do for Purple House. And please remember to call on us if you need any help or assistance over the next few weeks or months, and indeed over the Christmas period. Take care of yourselves. God bless.
Okay, I really love that song we've just sung, This Little Light of Mine. Since I was very young, I've been carrying this little light of mine everywhere I go, but there's actually a reason for that. And the reason for that is actually because I grew up in a farm. And on the farm, there was the cow milking shed was up a lane, and then the house, the home, was at the bottom of the lane. And every winter evening, when we finished the milking of the cows, my brother and I would make our way down the lane, but my brother would be holding the torch. And being an older brother, what he would do was he would run ahead, and he would hide, and he would switch off the torch. And I don't know which was worse, walking down in the darkness, or knowing that he was going to jump out at me. But that fear of the darkness stayed with me, because sooner or later he would appear and do this, and he would really scare the bejeepers out of me. Can you say bejeepers? Yes, you can. That's okay. And so that's why I carry this light. And this has been a pretty tough year for all of us on many, many levels. And the theme for all of us, I think, as we're in Advent and as we're in Christmas, has to be the theme of light and lightening the darkness. And I just want to encourage everybody just to remember that there is still light. The Christmas tree lights that you see going up early this year are a reminder of that light. The lights that you see on in the houses, even if families can't gather in the one place, are still reminders that people are there and we are there for one another. So I want to really encourage every one of you to carry a light. Not like me, a torch because you're afraid, but actually carry a light here. Carry a light that actually, with kindness, with a gentle word, with a reminder of a phone call or whatever, that the people are not alone. The Old Testament wrote, the prophet wrote, the people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. And on those who walked in the land of darkness, a light has shined. May the light of love that we feel here tonight, as we gather to celebrate all that has been good and true in Purple House, and all that continues to shine from this new centre, and may it be a blessing to all. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. That was the rehearsal.
All those who go in my way. And here we are at the unveiling of the Purple House Wall of Love. And these are people who have contributed and helped to get Purple House to where it is today in our beautiful new home of number 2 Dunkern Terrace. All of the people over the years, in the last 30 years, who have really been very helpful to get this community project off the ground, and we now have our permanent home that's going to be here forever, long after we're all gone. And this is a tribute to all those people over the last 30 years who have helped, both volunteered and financially supported Purple House Cancer Support to bring it where it is today in our beautiful new home.
I just want to say, just repeat what Brendan has said, and just say it is very heartening for us to be here now, 30 years later. I'm reminded of around our kitchen table in 1990 when we had the vision and we said the community needs a cancer support centre. And little did I realise that 30 years later, here we were with this beautiful house and beautiful building. So it is from the bottom of my heart, I want to say thank you to everybody who has come through my life in the past 30 years, but especially to my family who have supported me and been there for me through thick and thin. So it is with great pleasure now that I cut this purple ribbon to unveil our wall of love.
Thank you. Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, and fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. Your playing small doesn't serve the world. There's nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We are all born to manifest the glory of God within us. It's not just some of us, it's in everyone. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we are liberated from our fear, our presence automatically liberates others.
Oh, night. Thank you. Thank you. This is no place to call. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It wasn't snow, time's not stopping. And I have a awesome horn for popping. The lights are burning way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally meet, it's good night. Now I ain't going out in the storm. Hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still dividing. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Finally, it's the night, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still dividing. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Terrific tonight. You braved the weather, you turned up, and you were here in person, and there's a lot more with us in spirit and in at home and overseas. So from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank each and every one of you for all you've done for Purple House over the past 30 years, for everyone that has contributed in their own way. You have enriched all our lives. And hopefully next year you will be able to commit to this beautiful house. But before that, hopefully we're all very hopeful that the beginning of 2021 will bring better times and better days and a lot more hope. just remember that if you need us at all, we're here, even though restrictions have caused a little bit of havoc. But all you need to do is pick up the phone and call us. And our service has continued to know you. I also want to draw your attention to the stars and the doves and the hawks on the tree. People are dropping by the centre and writing the name of somebody that they love, somebody that they carry from, somebody that they have loved, or somebody they love that maybe they can't get to. And at least that's bringing the spirit of Christmas into all our hearts. So I wish you peace, I wish you health, and I wish you happiness. And just remember, we are here with you. Take care of yourselves. God bless. Bye-bye.